I'm Andras, Timar, Product Development Manager at Collabora Productivity. And we all have seen the excellent demonstration of Michael Meeks. So, he demonstrated Collabora Online and Nextcloud interaction. But I'd like to say something about what's under the hood. So, you know, the Collabora Online is not a standalone product. So we didn't implement storage, didn't implement authentication, because we are doing what we are best at, so developing LibreOffice, obviously, and the online parts. So here comes Nextcloud into the picture. So it has the storage, it has the user authentication, and we would like to put these together. We have been thinking about a protocol which can be used for communication between the storage and the Collabora Online. And fortunately, we found one. It's already an open standard, so-called. It's called VOPI, Web Application Open Platform Interface. So we just implemented part of this protocol, and it's basically an application for the Nextcloud. The source code is on GitHub, so we are accepting pull requests. And it consists of two parts. So the PHP part implements some REST endpoints that allow the transfer of the data. And there is a JavaScript part which loads the document into an iframe and starts to communicate to Collabora Online through a WebSocket. So basically, there are three REST endpoints that we need here. One is to get the document from the storage to the Collabora Online server. The second is to upload it back when we save. And the third is mandated by this VOPI protocol, the check file info, which can be used to transfer the file name, the username, the file size, and the file version, so we can even do versioning. So the authentication is done by a security token, which we generate on the Nextcloud side. It is passed to the LibreOffice or Collabora Online server, and Collabora Online server downloads the document using this security token, which is validated at the Nextcloud server side. So it's tied to a specific user session, and it can expire and has everything that it's required for proper authentication and authorization. The first step of the loading of a document is the calling of the so-called the discovery service. This is also part of the VOPI protocol. This discovery service tells the VOPI host, Nextcloud in this case, so what type of services can the VOPI client, the Collabora Online, can provide. For example, what document types are supported, or what document types are supported for viewing or editing. It's also possible to have different servers for different document types. In our cases, everything is the same, so it's not overcomplicated. Then we serve our JavaScript from the Collabora Online side. We will load it to an iframe within the Nextcloud, and then post the access token back to the server, and then we start to get tiles over the WebSocket So briefly, this is the architecture behind the Collabora Online and Nextcloud application. The source code is on GitHub, and I would like to invite you to our workshop after lunch, so we can discuss it in more details, and you can get involved. Thank you.